Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching Today I Found Out, and in the video today we're answering a viewer question because Jim Gordon asks, why are there D, C, AA, and AAA batteries, but no A or B batteries? Alright, so as Jim pointed out, common battery types include AA, AAA, C, and D. So why did they skip the others? Well, it turns out there are actually A and B batteries, but they aren't something you'll see stocked at most stores. Since the invention of the battery, there have actually been a pretty amazingly diverse range of batteries. They've used different sizes, shapes, voltages, storage capacities, etc., and they've all been named a wide variety of things. This eventually gave rise to the need for an industry-wide standard, particularly as the lack of an international or even national standard during World War I was really problematic for the military. As such, after World War I, the War Industries Board and several other government agencies got together to try to come up with a standard specification for batteries. A few years later, in 1928, the American Standards Association, the predecessor to the American National Standards Institute, ANSI, officially adopted this proposal, introducing a list of battery cell sizes and their corresponding label. For these labels, they suggested a convention that A would be the smallest, and as you went up the letters, the batteries would get larger in size. There was also a number 6 battery that was the largest. This was just adopted as it had previously been one of the most popular battery cell sizes, a 6-inch battery, so it was grandfathered in, though now given more strict guidelines to its exact specifications. Others came along later, such as the AAA size, which wasn't adopted into the standard until 1959. Since then, the ANSI standard for batteries has been revised numerous times as battery technology has evolved. Why it appears there are no B or other batteries anymore is simply because those particular battery sizes never really caught on commercially, at least on the consumer end of things. The ones that were most popular just ended up being the AA, the AAA, the C, and D. Nowadays, because those are the most commonly available to consumers, most manufacturers continue to use those battery types over the many other sizes that are available to power their devices. However, B batteries are still made and sold and pack a decent punch for their size. They are 21.5 mm by 60 mm and produce 1.5 volts and 8,350 milliamp hours for the alkaline variety. For reference, standard alkaline AAs ring in at 1.5 volts and 2,700 milliamp hours. A batteries are also still in production, last most commonly used in early model laptop battery packs. F batteries, on the other hand, are still sometimes used within something you can find at your local supermarket, rectangular 6-volt batteries. And now for a bonus fact. You'll sometimes hear that B batteries are no longer seen because they were primarily used in devices that used vacuum tubes, most commonly radios. It's said that they were specifically used as a battery to provide the plate voltage for the vacuum tube. Thus, as tube radios aren't too common anymore, the need for B batteries went away with them. But this isn't quite accurate. The B battery in the ANSI standard does not have the same specifications as the B battery used with vacuum tubes. The B battery in this case can refer to any single or group of cells used to give the plate a positive charge in order to draw the electrons from the filament. The voltage for these B batteries first started out needing 120 volts, then later typically needing 90, 67.5, 45, and 22.5. The value kept going down as tubes gradually became more efficient over time. Certainly, actual ANSI standard B batteries could be combined and used for this type of application, but really any battery or group of cells worked and would still be called a B battery in this context. This is thanks to the naming convention adopted for this use, A, B, and C, which specified what the battery was used for in the device, rather than the ANSI standard battery specification. So I really hope you found that video interesting, and here at Today I Found Out, we put up brand new videos every day of the week, so be sure to subscribe to get notified about those. Also, if you want something else to watch right now, check out the videos over there on the right. They're from our archive. I think you'll enjoy those if you like this one. And as always, thank you for watching.